الله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما اللهم فقهنا في الدين آمين. So today's topic is sabr. Sabr is patience. Everybody know what sabr is, right? Sabr means patience. So we're going to see the meaning of sabr and the detail of it, and we are following this book Husn-e Akhlaq, and in this chapter as-sabr, patience. So first I'm going to give the definition and what are the different ways the sabr has been used. Sabr is from Swad Bara. Sabr alal amr. Sabr alal amr is like, you know, showing bravery and being strong. Sabra alal amr is showing bravery and being strong. Okay. Sabran anshai. Sabra anshai, to stop oneself. To stop oneself from anything. Sabra anshai. Sabra dabba, to tie animal without any food. Sabra dabba, like, you know, tying the animal without any food or anything. That is sabra dabba. So here, you know, sometimes you have to do sabr for two things. Whether you like it, that also you have to do the sabr. Sometimes you don't like it, that time also you have to do sabr. Sabra la akrahu. Akrahu, like, you know, I stop oneself from which I dislike. Akrahu, from karaha. And sabra amra yuhibbu, like something which I like. Yuhibba is from hub, which I like, but I'm stopping myself. So there are certain times, you know, we're going to see the details, then we'll see the hadith and details about it. So here, people think sabr is, you know, when you do sabr and you are quiet and you are not answering and you are doing for the sake of Allah, people think, oh, she is very weak. It's not so. Doing sabr is a strong thing, is a big thing. You know, when you do sabr, literally, you know, it's like habsul nafs. Literally, you are strangling your neck, as if you are strangling your neck and you are stopping yourself. You could feel something, as if, you know, something, restlessness is there. Sometimes it's not easy, right? Not always it's easy, but you are stopping yourself for the sake of Allah. So here, as-sabur is the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as-sabur. So here, month of Ramadan, we call it shahrus sabr. Shahrus sabr, why? Because we stop ourselves with certain things, with certain timings, even though it's halal all the year, but that moment of time we are stopping ourselves from sunrise to sunset. So here, month of Ramadan taught us many things, like how we can do the sabr. Sabara, it means infertile or dry line. Sabara. And sabr, to stop oneself when you think you may slip. Stop oneself when you think you may slip from what the things which is liked or disliked. It can be either way, liked or disliked. Okay. The one thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shirk. Nauz billah, saying, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has walada, son. That's so hard, but still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does sabr. It comes in the Quran that it's near that heaven will split open and earth will burst with this kalima, saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has son. So Allah don't like, and you know, sometimes adding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with other deities, Allah don't like it. Shirk, you know, everybody, like contributing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making partner. Allah is one, everybody knows. Qulhu Allahu Ahad. If you see the translation, we believe in Islamic monotheism, oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah don't like, and that moment of time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does sabr. So here, you can do good deeds only when you have sabr. If you don't, you can't. For example, you are doing salah. For salah, first prerequisite is you have to be, you should have that tahara. Alhamdulillah, we have that knowledge. Even though we are going outside, still we keep our tahara. We keep ourselves pure and clean. And then later on, we do wudu the way it has to be done. And then we stand for the salah. At the time of salah, how we are doing sabr? Completely we are submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah is watching us. And we are committed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So same way, so if your goals are higher, you want to achieve Jannah, you have to do sabr. So here about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example. He is the role model for us. So he was orphaned when he was very young. Parents left, father died before he was born, and mother later on. This is the best example what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did sabr. No siblings. Like, you know, if somebody is all alone, they know how it is. Like, without siblings, it's very hard. You know, you don't have anybody to share anything. And, you know, grandfather, he was up to a certain age, he took care of. Then later on, his uncle, so on. Even after, you know, before getting the prophethood also, he was doing a lot of sabr. He was Sadiq and Amin. And he was so righteous. He never did anything bad, you should say. Because he's a prophet, all the prophets are innocent. And here, when he started the work of deen, he did lot of sabr. He faced all the problems, still he did the sabr. And sabr is bravery, is not weak, as I mentioned before. So here, without further delay, we're going to see what sabr and what this chapter says about it. Okay, as-sabr. قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. Surah Baqarah, ayah number 153. So here, Allah the Exalted says, O you who believe, seek help in patience and as-salat. Have you noticed here, first it says to the believers, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, those who believe, استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. استعينوا is from aun, you know, seeking help. From whom seeking help? With sabr and salat. So first, sabr is mentioned here. So without sabr, you can't do salah also. You know, you are standing for salah and sometimes, you know, something is cooking and our mind gets distracted. So until unless you do sabr, you can't properly have the khushu. So sabr is most important thing. And next thing is, قال الله تعالى إنما يوفى سابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Surah Zumar, ayah number 10. Allah the Exalted says, only those who are patient shall receive their reward in full without reckoning. Surah Zumar, ayah number 10. It says, إنما يوفى. يوفى is وفي. Giving completely يوفى سابرون أجرهم. The reward for them is given, ajrahum, for their reward, bi ghairi hisab, without any hisab, you know, without even calculating, okay, how much, you know. For example, you are doing some job and hourly they say, okay, this much amount. But it's not so. Bi ghairi hisab, without even counting like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is the key thing? Sabr. You have to do the sabr. And next here, from Rawahu Ibn Majah, Kitab al-Fatan 4032, this hadith has been taken from that. And it says, An Ibn Umar, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-Mu'minu al-Lazi yuqalitu al-Nas wa yasbiru ala azahum azamu ajran min al-Mu'min al-Lazi la yuqalitu al-Nas وَلَا يَسْبِرُوا عَلَىٰ أَزَاهُمْ. Translate. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma narrated, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believers who mingles with the people and is patient upon their harming him. see the word aza, you know, somebody is harming you and you feel bad. You are going and meeting the people and they're hurting you. Hurting in sense, not physical hurting, here hurting in your soul. Your heart has been hurt. Your soul has been hurt. They may say something which may hurt you, that aza. And then the believers who mingles with the people and is patient upon their harming him will have a greater reward than the believers who do not mingle. Here the word, you know, ajran minal mu'minin allazi la yuqalitu qalat, like, you know, meeting somebody. And instead of meeting someone, like, you know, if you go a particular place, you won't be comfortable. Still you are going it. Why? For the sake of Allah. Nobody is saying, like, you know, hurt yourself physically or mentally. Nobody. But up to a certain extent, we know our tolerance rate, right? I know mine, how much I can tolerate. You can stay up to that and then you can, without any thing on your face. Facially also, you shouldn't feel, okay, you don't want to come, but still you came. Don't even show with the facial expression, and also not with the gesture. That's the complete sabr, and that's with the people. Even though they can stay home, they are still meeting the people, so they will have the ajr. Who does, and the believers who does not mingle with the people and does not show patience upon their harming him. Comparing with the two people, one is harmed, one is not harmed. Why? One is sitting at home, so thinking that, okay, no, this is the thing, I can't go and, you know, do this. So here, if you go and still you do the sabr, and you come back, you know how much you can and how much time you can. Sometimes, you know, even on the phone you can do the sabr. Sometimes instead of cutting the relation, you can just talk to them, keeping the mind how much time. I don't think if you don't talk much, something may create bad, you know, that you know how to handle those situations. But not cutting off completely, not cutting off, you know, social circle, you are not going, or, you know, that's not the solution. With the one hadith, I'll complete, because next section is, inshallah, we'll start the tajweed session. Here, Suhaib radiallahu anhu narrated, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, strange is the case of believer. There is good for him in everything. This is the only for the believers. If a blessing reaches him, he is grateful to Allah, which is good for him. If an adversity reaches him, he is patient, which is good for him. So here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, for a believer, he's a strange. When good reaches him, this is the only for the believers. If it reaches him, he is grateful. Aren't we? We are grateful. Some blessing, we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which is good for him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is good for him. If an adversity reaches him, he is still patient. That is good for him. And the last thing, this thing, I request all of you to at least try to memorize this. The last hadith, I'm skipping two hadiths here and doing the last one because we don't have much time. Here, Sabit bin narrated that, I heard Anas radiallahu anha says that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, patience is at the first stroke of a calamity. Patience is at a first stroke of calamity. You know, when something happens, that moment of time I have to do sabr, not later on when friends are telling me and my relatives are saying, oh, this is the time you have to do. No, that moment of time. So that is, qala as-sabru in the sadmatil ula. As-sabru in the sadmatil ula. Only four words, inshallah, I'll send you in the group. So this thing we have to do at the time when you have to do the sabr, inshallah. That moment of time you have to do. So with this we end this session, inshallah.